Wir sind Pilawa und Kerner von ZDF Kultur und wir melden uns aus unserem großen Fernsehgarten, den wir hier Rockenheim nennen. Ein Festival, was es dieses Jahr zum allerersten Mal gibt, am Hockenheimring. Großartige Bands sind hier und jetzt gibt es wieder mal ein Highlight für euch.
Und nicht nur Andrea Kiewitz laufen hier rum, nein, Gott sei Dank laufen hier Personen und Menschen rum, die so sensationelle Musik machen, dass 40.000 Menschen gekommen sind, um sich die Musik anzuhören. Und ihr seid ja Gott sei Dank auch dabei, um sich das nochmal im Fernsehen anzuschauen.
Man kann auch mitklatschen und schunkeln.
Ja, kann man alles zu Hause machen, wie im Fernsehgarten. Ja. Alles möglich. Jetzt mit einer Band, ich würde sagen, ist eines der Highlights von diesem Festival. Die Band heißt Franz Ferdinand. Der eine oder die andere hat es vielleicht schon mal gehört.
Ja, das ist die Flipper der Alternative-Szene.
Genau.
Ja.
Sie haben ein neues Album, es heißt Right Thoughts, Right Words, Right Action. Sie haben versprochen, sie werden es heute auch zum Besten geben.
Hoffentlich. Ja?
Das heißt, schunkelt euch schon mal ein.
Ja.
Live vom Rockenheim.
Und diesmal nicht Playback. In diesem Sinne, viel Spaß.
Hello, Rockenheim. It's very touching to see so many of you out tonight. We're Franz Ferdinand. How you doing? You all right? That sounds pretty good. Well, we're going to have a pretty good time tonight. And we want to make sure that you do too. Because when I woke up tonight, I said I'm going to make... Well, when I woke up tonight, I said I'm going to make somebody. Well, to you, Thoughts, right words, right actions.
But how can we leave you?
weather permitting. It's really touching to see these Scottish flags in the audience. That's really nice. And I like these guys over here who are moving to the beat. Yeah, I like y'all, I like y'all. Don't worry, you're all cool, but these guys are moving in a good way. Come to me, baby, you're the North Sea sings. Come to
to me.
Es ist heiß auf dem Rockenheim Festival und es wird immer heißer. Franz Ferdinand geben uns die Ehre in ZDF Kultur. Hi, how are you doing, Alex?
Hello, I'm good, thanks.
Right Thoughts, Right Words, Right Action is the title of the album, which is just about to come out. Mm. Are you so experienced that you just don't give a shit, or is it still like getting a baby?
I love it. It's a very exciting experience. I was trying to explain it to my girlfriend. I was saying, it's a little bit like, you know, before it's somebody's birthday or at Christmas when you've wrapped up a present for somebody and you know what it is that they're going to get, but they don't know what it is yet, but they know that it's coming. It feels a little bit like that. You know, you've put all this preparation into something and it's quite a nice idea that you've made this thing and the rest of the world are going to get to see what it is quite soon.
But sometimes people unpack presents and they're like, oh, thank you.
I didn't want that. Yeah, yeah. Of course. Yes, yes.
What if that
happens? And that's part of the sensation, isn't it? Because you think, I hope they're going to like it. Yeah, you know, of course. And that's the way it is with a present. And it's the same way with an album. You're right.
You once said it's probably the most optimistic and positive album. In which way?
Yeah, yeah. I think the mood of the band, as we were making the record, when we were in the studio, you know, it just felt good. It felt, you know,
like better than
a good place to be. I'd say certainly better than the last. It just felt good. It just felt good. And I mean, these things are all relative. Like, I wouldn't say there was any time that we felt miserable in the studio, but there were. But with this record, it just felt very natural and like the right place to be.
There was also a collaboration with Hot Chip, which is
sure,
actually
yeah.
More like electro outfit. How could they help you out?
Well, the guys from Hot Chip, we did a collaboration on the production with Alexis and Joe from Hot Chip, and it came about, like a lot of things happened with us. We went to the pub, you know, met up with Alexis and Joe and said, hey guys, what you been up to? And they said, well, we just finished recording our album and in a few weeks we're going away on tour. And we said, well, do you fancy going to the studio, see what happens? And they were, sure. So what are you doing tomorrow? Nothing. Let's meet up. And so we did. And, you know, like everything that you do creatively, you give it a go. Sometimes it works. Sometimes it doesn't work. And with Alexis and Joe, they're really natural, easygoing people that they're good to hang about with. And the music that they make probably sounds quite different from ours. The elements, particularly in the way that they approach it and the thought behind the music, which is quite similar to the way that we make music, it's quite intuitive. It's driven by rhythm. It's quite soulful music. It's yeah, of course, it's danceable music, and I think we're both. It's funny because although they're a dance band, there's so much melody in what they produce as a band as well. And even though we're a rock and roll band, it's not just about melody. There's a lot to do with the rhythm for us. And I think we're almost mirror images of each other. I think as bands. You know.
Stop, no, won't stop feeling, and the fun's not
anymore. But I can't stop, no, won't stop feeling, 'cause you leave me dancing alone. Yeah, you leave me to die on the floor. Oh, you can't feel it, you can't feel it. Oh, you can't feel it, oh, you can't feel it anymore. I feel it anymore, I feel it anymore. Sure. Rockenheim, I'm having a good time. I don't know if you're having a good time, but I am having a good... Are you having a good time? Well, I'm definitely having a good time. I'll never get your bullet out of my head. We'll be right back.
Get it burning time! size, the boring wings for me, they paralyze, destroying so sweetly. But now there is a fire in me. You say that you don't know.
You've already played a couple of your new songs.
Played all of them.
Like, all of them,
yeah,
live.
Yeah.
How did it go?
You know, this is the first time we've made a record where we've played all the songs live before we've released the record. And even the first record, there were a couple that we'd recorded and before we played them live. Felt pretty good. Yeah, you know, and it's nice as well. See, I quite like this age that we're in at the moment. Like, I see a lot of musicians moaning about, oh, songs go on YouTube and they get heard. I think if you've got a good song, let people hear it. It's a good thing.
But people say they have to earn money, and they
don't
want
songs. Of course you earn money. And like, I think that a version that we play live, say we play a new song tonight here at Rockenheim, and somebody records it on their phone, it's a pretty crappy recording. Even if you've got the loveliest smartphone in the world, it's going to be a pretty crappy recording. And so if you want to hear the song properly recorded, then you've still got to splash out on the record, you know.
Yeah, you're right.
But at the same time, I don't give a damn if people are hearing it on the phones. Yeah, have a glimpse of the song. Why not? You know.
I just saw Universe Expanded live from Moscow.
Oh, right.
Recorded by a phone.
Right, right.
It's just crap.
Yeah.
But let's talk about this song. What's the story behind it? There's quite a nice, you know, connection to the body as well.
Sure, yeah. This song is about this idea that it's based on this idea that the universe is expanding. We all know this principle. The universe is expanding. It's going to get to a certain point where it can expand no more. And when it reaches that point, it'll start to contract again. And not only distance will contract, but time will contract as well. And as time contracts, it will start to travel backwards. And the idea
Einstein-like.
What's that, sorry?
Einstein-like.
I don't know who came up with the theory. It probably is a sort of Einstein theory. I should look that up. Really.
I think it's based on the principle.
Right, yeah. I'm sure it is. It's all probably to do with relativity.
So sorry. Just
And so the song is about somebody who's trying to come to terms with a catastrophic termination of a love affair. A love affair has gone wrong and it's ended. And they're consoling themselves thinking that, well, one day time will start traveling backwards after the universe has expanded all those millions of years away. And there'll come a day when I get to live the love affair backwards and it's a bit more positive on the way back. And so everything starts at this terrible negative end and then it comes back to a more positive place at the beginning.
Beautiful.
Well,
what does it mean, like, musically wise?
I guess it's funny because Bob and I were writing the song. We had the idea for the song. And when I was writing the music, I was trying to write, sort of like establishing the chords and the key, and then trying to play notes that felt that they were disconnected from the key of the song. So almost like the notes are floating in the void while you're singing them. Like, sort of disconnected. You know, that feeling of imagining being lonely in the void somewhere, waiting for time to travel backwards.
Oh, what a beautiful ending. One last word, first time in Rockenheim, because it's the first time Rockenheim takes place.
Yeah.
First impression?
It seems like a good place for a festival. I was talking to my friends in the band earlier and saying it's very rarely that you get to say, I was at the very first year of that festival. You know, who gets to say we played Glastonbury the first year of Glastonbury? You know, very few bands. I think T-Rex maybe, but yeah. So that's quite a privilege, I think, getting to be there at the first time.
Thank you very much, Franz Ferdinand. Also in ZDF Kultur auf dem Rockenheim Festival.
Thank you. Cheers. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Tonight, I'm enjoying myself. Rockin' High, thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. We were Franz Ferdinand. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.
Vielen Dank. Wir waren Franz Ferdinand.
See you next time.